And a reminder, there's a blood moon coming in. It's got everyone talking, but what exactly is a blood moon? Jonathan is here to explain more on that and breaking it down for us. And, of course, tell us a little bit more about it, what it really means, and the history behind it, too.
Well, you need to know about the timing of it on Wednesday night. Mm-hmm. As it goes into the overnight hours, you're going to want to definitely be aware of the timing of the different stages of it. So let me show you a great graphic. And what we're talking about when we say blood moon, we're talking about the total lunar eclipse. And so, essentially, the Earth's shadow getting cast upon the moon. So let's take you through here. As I click through, you'll notice that certain time frames are getting illuminated here, yellow, and so that's indicating that this particular stage here at 10:55, the deep penumbral stage, basically, is this is when right before the moon is starting to enter the Earth's shadow, and then once it does, you're going to see the moon turn dark first, and then once it's completely within that Earth's shadow, which is the umbra, that is when it will turn red, and that's why it's a blood moon, and then it will continue on until the eclipse ends around 1:30 a.m. going into the 14th, and then it will again enter the stage of the penumbral stage, exiting the eclipse phase. And so that is the look at the timing. You don't want to miss it. The question really is, will we have clouds? Will you be able to get a good view of it? I think we'll be okay. It's not the best forecast, but we have some clouds out there on Wednesday night. It just it's going to be a partly cloudy evening. You'll have to kind of hope that you get some breaks in those clouds on Wednesday night.